Hi, my name is Luiz da Costa, and today I would like to talk about the work that the Laboratório Interinstitucional de Astronomia, or LINEA, has been doing for the past 10 years, supporting the participation of Brazilian scientists in large astronomical surveys. This work has also the support, critical support, I would say, from the INCT do Universo. LINEA was created 10 years ago with the intention of providing the big data infrastructure necessary for the participation of Brazilian science in big science. So the first project we joined was the Dark Energy Survey back in 2006. And since then we have joined several other surveys. And today we give sophisticated support to all members, including people from the INCT of the universe. This infrastructure consists of processing hardware, infrastructure for processing, a data repository with data from the large surveys that we are involved, an intense program of software development and service in general. We have our own hardware infrastructure, which is dedicated to our work. It consists of machines optimized for data transfer, which is critical in our case, virtual machines that keep different services that we offer our members, two databases, one for data from Sloan using the Microsoft SQL server, and then another one for the Dark Energy Survey with data with the Postgres SQL. We also have storages, including a new brand new Lustre system for HPC work. In total, we have 1.5 petabytes, and we have processing clusters totaling about 25 teraflops. All of our machines at LNCC, co-located with the supercomputer Santos Dumont, which we also have access to. During the 10 years of work, we have built several science platforms, some for visualization of the data that we are getting as part of the surveys. We have built one for the Dark Energy Survey, whereby we can visualize objects superposed to the images and also make queries in the database to define targets for different applications. We have also built another one for the Sloan Digital Sky Survey, which is helps us to visualize the data cubes produced by an instrument consisting of the integral field unit. And so we have not only the light distribution across the image, but also you have a third dimension, which is the spectra at each position of the object. We also have developed a very sophisticated analysis systems, one for the Dark Energy Survey, which hosts a whole bunch of pipelines and workflows, science workflows, that not only prepares and produces science-ready catalogs, but also has workflows for different applications, like identifying clusters of gaps, this evolution of the Lorentz function, and several others. And we also have developed more recently one for the solar system group, whereby we can identify and generate orbits for all the solar system, known solar system objects that have been detected in the 180,000 exposures taken by the Dark Energy Survey along the 6 years of operation. The challenge now is to scale all of our work to the Legacy Survey of Space and Time, LSST. This is a survey that will be conducted at the Vera Rubin Observatory in Cerro Pachón, Chile. It will generate 40 times the data of DES. It will operate for 10 years from 2023 to 2033. It will cover half of the sky in six bands, and each point of the sky will be visited 800 times. So you actually not only going to produce very deep images by co-adding all the single epoch exposures, but also produce a little movie of the dynamical universe that opens up a new domain of research. It will generate 15 terabytes of data a night, 10 million alerts that anything that brightens or position of objects that change during the night, and will detect about 36 billion objects. This is just to give an idea of how big the field of view is. It consists of about 180 CCDs, totaling 3.0 gigapixels, and you could fit in the field of view about 40 full moons. The data will flow from the telescope to a base camp in Chile, in La Serena, and then after that, we'll go to the U.S. data facility, which will be located now in SLAC, in the California, and half of the data will move to Europe that will help process the data. After the data is reduced, it will be distributed to independent data access centers, which will hold not necessarily all of the data, but the catalog of objects. Linea, in fact, has submitted a proposal to DOE NSF to host one of these IDECs in Brazil. The benefits of having a Brazilian IDEC are enormous. First of all, increases the number of Brazilian scientists in the project because it is considered an in-kind contribution. And we'll have the data near our processing infrastructure so we can use our tools and algorithms and portal. It helps us create a Brazilian data center combined with the data that we have from the other surveys. And all of that will hopefully incentivize the creation of a data intensive research institute. And that's the new mission of Fadenia for the next few years. Thank you very much.